हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे इन द लास्ट डे वी डिस्कस सम बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स एंड द फर्दर मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स कॉन्सेप्ट्स आर नंबर वन दैट इज ग्रोस एंड नेट इन्वेस्टमेंट. In the last module, we discuss different macroeconomic concepts. In further, next is gross and net investment. Then first, what is gross investment? Gross investment. Gross investment means change in the capital stock, including depreciation, or you can say without adjusting the amount of depreciation on fixed asset. Change in capital stock or addition in the capital stock. Additional in capital stock. Capital stock can be considered as the fixed asset of a business. And in economic, these are the fixed asset, or that is called capital stock. When that capital stock is increased by a specific amount or by actual amount, that is called gross investment, and that also include the depreciation of such assets which may be due to their regular use. And second concept is net investment. It is also change in the capital stock of the asset or capital stock or addition in the capital stock, but difference is that here the depreciation is excluded from the gross value of the investment. It is net actual addition in the value of fixed asset, or you can say capital stock. That net change in the value of capital stock is called net investment. It means net investment is equal to gross investment minus depreciation. Now, what is the depreciation? As earlier, if you listen about the depreciation, we say that the depreciation is the decrease in the value or fall in the value of fixed asset constantly due to normal tear and wear, their normal obsolescence. And due to passes of time, due to any reason, when the value of the fixed asset falls or decrease, that change or fall in the value of or decrease in the value of asset is called depreciation. When the depreciation is adjusted from the gross investment, then the net balance is called net investment, or when the depreciation is included in the value of investment, that is called gross investment. Here we discuss depreciation. Depreciation means decrease in the value of fixed asset due to any reasons. Same term is sometimes we use a word is that is capital loss. Some students don't know that what is the difference between the depreciation and capital loss. But there is a difference between the depreciation and capital loss. Like that, depreciation is the decrease in the value of fixed asset due to their regular use or due to their normal wear and tears, normal obsolescence of the technology or passage of time. But capital loss is a sudden loss in the value of a fixed asset due to any reason. Like that, sometimes some fixed assets that got an accident and their value decrease by a certain amount, that decrease in the value of fixed asset is called capital loss. And the capital loss hampered the production process, but depreciation not hampered the process of production because it is by chance, but depreciation is regular use. Second is, there can be make a provision for the depreciation to purchase the further new asset or new capital stock, but there is no provision is made for the capital loss because they happen suddenly in the value of a fixed asset. So these terms may be considered differently, that what is the depreciation and what is the capital loss. So these are the two terms, one is gross investment and next is net investment, which are considered to measure the value of national income of economy or a country. Next is net factor income from abroad. Net factor income from abroad. When we calculate the value of or measure the value of national income, this term is also play very important role. Then what is that term is called in the short NFIE, net factor income from abroad. What is this? You say that there are two type of the person, some of the normal resident of country, normal resident of the country, and some are not normal resident of country. When a income received by the normal resident of a country from the abroad, from income received from abroad, that is called income received from abroad. And when the income received by the non-resident of India or non-resident of a country from a particular country, that is called income paid to the normal residents, or that is income received by the abroad persons or foreign persons. The difference between both, net factor income is received from abroad, income received from abroad by the normal resident of a country, minus income paid to foreigners. The difference between both is called net factor income from abroad, that is income received from abroad by the normal resident of a country, and income paid to foreigners by a particular country, the difference is called net factor income from abroad. And that is a major term in the calculation of national income of a country. Our next term is, that is net indirect taxes. Net indirect taxes. Now, what is the net indirect taxes? As you say that there are various type of the taxes, but here we discuss only indirect taxes. Indirect taxes after the 2017, they are considered as or merged in a common tax system, that is called GST. But here we are using the net indirect taxes, that is also called NIT. There are two terms to calculate the NIT. One is indirect taxes and second is subsidies. And NIT is equal to indirect taxes. You can say that GST minus subsidies. Now, what is indirect taxes? Indirect taxes are those taxes which are imposed by the government on the producers or sellers on their productions and the sale value of the goods and services. It means those taxes which are imposed by the government on the producers or the production and the sale of goods, but they are indirect. Indirect means they are not paid by those person to whom they are imposed, but they are shifted to other person. Like that, if the government impose a amount of tax on the producer and the producer add that taxes in the price of goods, and then such taxes are bear by the customers or consumers, so they are shifted on other persons. Such type of taxes are called indirect taxes. Nowadays they are called GST, in the form of GST, and GST is the group of various type of indirect taxes which are already in the form of sale tax, excise tax, and various further type of the state and central level taxes. All these taxes now they are considered as GST or indirect taxes. Second term is subsidies. Subsidies means like that the taxes are paid by producers and sellers or public to the government. Same, some financial aid or assistance are given by the government to producers or seller. That financial assistance is called subsidies, which are given by the government to producers or seller. So it is the inflow from the government sector to the production sectors, and taxes are the outflow of production sector to the government sectors. So this is paid by the producers to the government, and this is paid by the government sector to production sector. The difference of both is called net indirect taxes, and net indirect taxes are also used to measure the national income of a country. So these are some basic terms or basic concepts of the national income in the macroeconomics, which are used to calculate or measure the national income of a country. In the previous modules we are also discussed already, like that number one is our, that is domestic territory. Second is normal residence of a persons. Then we consider the types of the goods. We can final goods or intermediate goods. Then we consider the factor payments or transfer payments. Then we consider the net factor income from abroad. Then we consider the gross and net investment. And net indirect taxes. There are various macro concepts which are used to measure the national income of a country.